This is what I'd call a standard helicopter head. It's a Bell helicopters, which is what you'd find in a Bell 206 or a Huey. In this, you have one single pivot point, and it pivots about one point, much like a child's seesaw, pivoting up and down with the blades on the end. When we go to a Robinson head, to achieve a lightweight and responsive design, they've gone for three pivot points. What that allows is for the blades to pivot independently of each other, so they're pivoting up and down here in a flapping situation. When you get to a mast bump situation on a standard head, as long as it's not so severe that it comes down and it severs the mast, the hub will come down and strike the mast, may put a dent in it, and you'll give yourself a fright and carry on flying and land shortly afterwards. On the Robinson head, once you get the hub striking the mast, with Newton's third law, there will be actions and reactions. The reaction is that the blade will pop up out of what we call an out-of-track situation. It'll just come up there as a natural reaction. Once it's out of track, there will be an out-of-balance situation will develop very quickly in the hub. So you'll have the hub pivoting about that one single point out of balance and the blade out of track. Normally when it gets to that stage, it is unrecoverable. It's going to happen extremely quickly and extremely violently. In support of Robinson helicopters with their flight manual, in turbulence that you'd find here in New Zealand, they require you to reduce to 70 knots. That limitation is there for a reason. It is to do with the hub design, which is quite different to a standard design.